Hi there, welcome to this video on working with images in Syncfusion Dashboard. Syncfusion Dashboard provides image widget to display both static and dynamic images. You can use the image widget to display static images like a logo of a company or dynamic images like the image of a product or a salesperson as shown in this dashboard. In this video, I'm going to explain the different formatting options available in the image widget. I have the latest dashboard designer installed in my machine, and I have also added a new data source by clicking the Add Data Source button. In my data source, I have the sales details of a company in one of the tables, and I also have the employee details including the profile image in another table. Now I am going to create a dashboard to display the sales performance of the employees. Let me rename the data source as sales details. Also, let me rename the dashboard as sales performance. I have built the dashboard. The dashboard now contains various details including total lead, converted leads, and also the comparison between current month and previous month. I have a combo box filter element over here. By making use of this filter element, I can choose one salesperson at a time and view the details specific to that particular salesperson. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to add an image widget at the left corner so that whenever a salesperson is selected, the corresponding person's profile picture would be displayed. You can find the image widget in the miscellaneous category of the toolbox. Let me drag this and resize it. You can configure the image widget by clicking the configure button. As said earlier, the image widget has the ability to display both static and dynamic images. To display a static image, uncheck the bind from database option and select an image using the file picker. Click the set image button and select the image. The bind from database option allows you to load dynamic images. Images can be loaded from binary data in your database and also from web URL. Let us see this one by one. In my data source, as said earlier, I have the profile picture as binary data in one of the fields. Let me go back to the image widget, and in the data section, let me drag and drop the profile field. The image is now rendered as we expected. Let me go back to the dashboard and click the preview button to check how this is displayed in the dashboard viewer. The dashboard is now rendered as we expected in the dashboard viewer. Let me choose some other employee. You can see the images are dynamically loaded based on the selected salesperson. Now let us take a look at the URI option. You can provide the web URL of your image and load the images dynamically. Let me show you an example for this. In my website, I have the profile pictures of the employees. As you can already see, the URL contains a pattern. It contains the employee ID and the image name, and these parameters changes for each and every individual employee. Let me copy this link and paste it over the pattern text box. Instead of providing a static link, I'm going to replace both these fields, that is the employee ID and the image name, with arguments so that the image can be dynamically changed and the corresponding images can be loaded. Let me edit this and replace the field with arguments in curly braces. The dynamic link with pattern is now constructed successfully. In my database, I have the employee ID field and also the image name in the image link field. So let me go back to the image widget, and in the data section, I have to provide the values for the arguments. The first argument is the employee ID. So let me remove this and drag and drop the employee ID field over here. And the second argument is the image name. I have it in the image link field. So let me drag and drop this. You can see the image is now loaded successfully. Let me go back to the dashboard and click the preview button to see how this is rendered in the dashboard viewer. You can see the images are now picked up based upon the selected salesperson and it is displayed. Let me change the salesperson. This is how the URI option can be used to load dynamic images. In case if you have the complete hyperlink to the image in the database itself, go to the image widget and in the pattern text box provide an empty argument. In the data section, you can directly add the hyperlink to the column. You can see the image is now rendered. Now let us go ahead and publish this dashboard to the dashboard server. From the server menu, choose the publish dashboard option. Click the publish button to publish the dashboard. The dashboard is now published successfully. We have the published dashboard over here. Let me select another salesperson and check how the image widget is rendered. The dashboard is rendered as we expected. The dashboard designer also provides customizations to modify the image mode. There are several modes available. There is a default mode in which the image will be preserved in its original size. We have the fill mode where the image will be stretched across the entire image widget. In the uniform mode, the original aspect ratio of the image will be preserved. You can check all these details in the documentation link available in the description below. You can choose one of the image modes and render the image as per your requirement. There is also an ignore filter actions option available. In case if your image is bound from the database and you have to ignore the filter actions, you can use this option. This option may be ineffective if you are loading a static image using the browse image option. This is how you can use the image widget to load static and dynamic images in your business dashboards. Thanks for watching.